Hi and welcome to this edition of Out the Box. My name's Paul. Today we're going to have a look at what is in this box. This is the Ubiquiti Dream Machine Pro Max. Let me go through what you get in the box. We'll talk a bit about the unit as we go along, but it's not going to be a big technical overview. There's plenty of those out on the internet, plenty in the spec sheets. You are going to get your conformity guide, which will probably never come out of the wrapping. You are going to get your power cable. It is an IEC connector at that end. This happens to be European there, but it will be changed for the region that you are in. You are going to get a pair of rack ears because you can rack mount this. There we go. And then you're going to get a packet of screws and lugs. Here we go. So everything you need to be able to mount it in the rack. Down this end here, you've got all the screws to be able to mount the rack ears there. And then you've got some bolts and nuts there to be able to mount it directly in to the rack. Then we've got the unit itself. So let's show you around that. Solid aluminium construction, as you can see. You've got an 8-port switch up this end here. We've got a 2.4, I'm trying to get myself in the right, we've got a 2.5 gigabit a second internet connection, and we've also got options here for a 10 gig and a 10 gig LAN as well. So that's part of the difference between that and the Ubiquiti Dream Machine Special Edition. Here we only have non-PoE ports. All right, to be fair, the idea of this is a faster controller that probably you're going to be doing the ports, the switching, and the PoE out on a separate switch. As you can see across the top, we have these vents. These are mirrored then on the back here as well. And this is for air draw from front to back. You can also see here we have two hard drive bays. So now we can actually do a RAID in these where we couldn't have before because it only took one hard drive, or we can build slightly bigger capacity. Then right at the end here, we've got our small LCD screen that gives us obviously what IP it's on, throughputs and various other bits and pieces. Nothing really to see on the sides. Then just on the back, I'll hold that up. You can see again the cooling vents that we've got. And then obviously up this end here, we have got our IEC connector input. And if you've got one of the leads that's custom made, it will lock into place over there. Then at this end here, if you do anything with RPS, the redundant power system, it's not a UPS, it's an RPS, then that's for that module there. So look, this is a faster model. It's meant to be twice the speed of the original one, so the UDM Special Edition. It can handle hundreds of access points, hundreds of switches. So if you're looking for a jump up, you're trying to handle more cameras, you want greater redundancy and have two hard drives in here, you need a faster internet connection, so you want to use that multi-gig interface, that 2.5 gigabit a second interface, then this model could be worthwhile for you. But just note the fact, no PoE ports, but it's not a game changer for most people, especially if you've got a whole bunch of cameras. This is not going to really go very far anyway. So one last hold up there. Hopefully that's been useful to have a look at. This has been the Ubiquiti Dream Machine Pro Max. Why don't you head on over to our YouTube channel? Got plenty more box openings on network, firewall, wireless, camera security, plenty of how-to guides. What do I need to run UniFi Protect or UniFi Network or all of those types of things. So hopefully you find that useful. You'll subscribe and stay up to date.